They thought he was gone. They thought he was dead forever. Well, Eggy Crunchy Pop is back with a vengeance to show them how to actually run a podcast. In this podcast, we've got Greg, Destructionator, back for a second time, and a third. New guest, Silent, third time, who cares? And Eggy Crunchy Pop is back with a vengeance. This summer, Eggy Crunchy Bob is here to scramble your faces.
That was good.
That was how
you do an intro.
That was like one of the greatest intros I've ever heard in my life. So welcome, guys. This is the Titties, Titties, Titties podcast. And like we said, we have Destructinator. We have Silent, who's a new guest. Make sure you guys check out their channels down in the description. And also Eggy's channel. As well, that'd be greatly appreciated, guys.
Doing YouTube again.
Yeah,
I upload supply drop openings, reacting to supply drop openings, reacting to supply drop openings, and reacting to reactions of reacting to supply drop openings.
Is that a reference? I hear there, Sam.
He actually did a react.
I did a reacting to a
I uploaded a supply drop opening video.
Oh, shit.
You actually did? Yeah, because Greg did one.
I'll explain this.
I'm out. If you guys are seriously doing reaction videos, I'm off. Done.
No, literally, like, I did a supply drop opening video, and it's, like, my most viewed video, and then Chuck did a reacting to it and basically made fun of me, and then Nader did one to Chuck.
Oh, like, really? Chuck's making fun of you for
making
that.
Making fun
okay.
of Chuck.
For making fun of Greg.
Yeah, and then Bassie.
And then Bassie did one where he put his dog in it.
He literally dog in the corner and, like, typed, which was really funny.
There was literally a face cam in three of the four corners. It was hilarious.
Oh, my God. I gotta go look this up after we do this.
All right. So, anyways, guys, today we have a bunch of questions from you guys, as you guys know.
I'm going to interrupt you. Seriously, Chuck made fun of you? Chuck? Really? Like, he has a leg to stand on? Okay, Chuck.
Okay, this was before he turned his channel around into the opposite direction. But anyways, guys, we have questions, as you guys know. You can ask your questions down below. Make sure they are entertaining, crazy, amazing, and awesome. And if you guys just leave a normal comment like good video, then I'm going to be pissed off because we don't need the comment section filling up with that. We already know this podcast is amazing and it's already good. You don't need to tell us that. No, seriously, guys, just ask questions, please. That'd be greatly appreciated. You can also say it's a good podcast to make me feel good about myself when I am...
Oh, my God. Pick a stance, Greg.
All right, whatever. Yeah. Screw it. Let's go.
Didn't we say we're going to, like, live stream this one so we could get questions while recording it?
Yeah.
What happened to that?
Greg is lazy. Okay, moving on. Question one.
Okay. This is from... I can't say this name
Anthony
any differently.
Juarez.
I'm sorry. No, Anthony Juarez.
Juarez.
So there's this kid I sit next to. He's hella annoying. His breath stinks. Like wet $H! Exclamation point T. And like I said, he's annoying. He also call him Forehead. Or we also call him Forehead. Okay. But how I tell him he's all of these things?
Kind of sounds like you're already doing it.
It kind of sounds like you need to pay attention in class.
I didn't realize you sat next to Greg.
Thank you for the young age compliment, I guess.
Oh, yeah, wait, never mind. I didn't know you sat next to Greg's son.
Okay. let's pull this back on board, guys. And Anthony, listen up real quick, all right? First of all, what you need to do is you need to bring in gum. Offer him a piece of gum. All right? Give him that piece of gum so his breath doesn't smell. Then what you do is you say you're annoying after giving him the piece of gum. So maybe he thinks you're kidding, but you're really not. And that way you can basically tell him that he's annoying without really hurting his feelings. And then also, if he backfires and says, like, a backfire response to that, his breath won't stink because you already gave him a piece of gum. Boom.
Wow, that was...
He just dropped the knowledge on you.
That was so unentertaining.
That was actually pretty good.
Look, personal experience. There's a guy in my college who is inside the gaming group that I'm involved in, and let's just say he's about... twice as bad as this guy, because it's not just his breath that stinks, but he just... I don't think he's taken a shower in about 20 years. So, He likes to sit with everybody. You can smell him across the table. He walks by the table and the smell lingers in the air. It's actually like a moist smell.
I hate that.
It just kind of lingers there. And yeah, we just kind of don't talk to him anymore. He doesn't. We shunned him.
So there was this guy I used to work with, and me and actually a lot of people, we were kind of like, it didn't consume us, but we were kind of a little envious of him because he used to be in the army, and like he's a good looking dude. He's very friendly. He doesn't fake it, but he's like one of those people who's like. Like I describe him as like a Mormon. Like they're constantly happy and like cheerful, and they're like, "Yeah, let's do this, dude. You know, everything's cool." But he's genuine about it, so you can't get mad at him. But the thing is that like he's a good-looking dude, and he's like, I've worked out with him, and the dude's got like a freaking rocking body. I'm like, "Fuck, man!" Like you know, it's like, man, I wish I had all that. And then like it's not like a constant thing. It was just like maybe once or twice. We were like hanging out and like he came into the group. He's like, "Hey guys, what's up? I'm here." And like, I'm not like trying to be hyperbolic or anything like that. His breath literally smelled like fucking manure. Like, and no, it wasn't like, he worked on a farm and he might've stepped in it. Like his breath smelled like liquid manure. I didn't tell him. I just was like, "Oh shit, I gotta go. Bye." But nice. Advice for your friend is, so you ever see the show Intervention? Yeah, just do that with a couple of dentists and send them down and just be totally serious about it and be like, "Look, we're worried about tooth decay for you. Gum disease is not something to laugh about." And then at the end of it, once everyone's crying and hugging each other, you go, "Oh, by the way, you're an annoying bitch. See ya." Practical.
What a way to end an intervention.
I have bus. Like a really quick story about personal hygiene. So I took a video production class for my major. Like, I think it was.
Oh, I remember this story. Is this the butt crack story?
Yeah. 2 semesters ago, right? So there was this kid who was probably like 300 pounds, really like just gross. Like, his hair was greasy. He had dandruff all in his hair. He basically sat in front of me, right? And he would get freaking dandruff on my iPad from like leaning back in his chair. So I was like pretty fed up with that. Not to mention he also wore shirts that were too small for him. Ugh. And I'm pretty sure they were like double XL too, and they were too small still. And also like the shorts he wore were like basically pajama shorts, almost like thin, like thickness, like they're just really bad. So anyways, basically like he would literally, you would see like his butt crack the entire time, like it really bad, and it looked gross too. Like I don't even want to mention it, but basically, to make a long story short, we like everyone else in the class would talk about it, and like at the end of the year we had a project, and it was right before Christmas time, and he was the cameraman while I was directing my project. Because we had to basically write a script and make like a 30-second commercial or something. So I'm talking in the freaking control room with like everyone in there saying like we should pitch in and like buy him like bigger shirts or something. And the freaking mic was unmuted. So he heard the entire thing. And it turns out that this butt crack that we saw was actually a surgery that he had because he couldn't walk when he was like 10 years old.
Oh wow, you guys are dicks.
Yeah, so like it just goes to show like you can really hurt people's feelings. Like I felt like the biggest asshole after that, but like it was still, I think it was a pretty good story to be honest. But
okay, so next one is Pitskate 012.
Oh, this guy again.
2 questions. Okay, have a rewind button or pause button in your life? I mean, I guess like rewind, like assuming that like you can change it, or it's just like rewind that you can relive it again, but you don't have control over changing it. I don't know. I mean, if that's the case, like, if you change shit, fuck yeah, dude, I would change shit as, in a heartbeat. Like, fuck the butterfly effect. Like, man, because you just like, if the butterfly effect happens and it's just like, oh man, you shouldn't change that because then it became worse. It's like, fuck it, I'll rewind again and keep trying until I find.
That is literally the plot of every time travel movie ever, where they try to do that and they just keep fucking shit up until they finally go back all the way and stop themselves from time traveling in the first place.
I know, but here's the thing, though. They never, like, you can't do this in a movie because there's a finite amount of time in a movie that you can, you know, show stuff in a plot. But, like, eventually, like, if you keep going back and it's, like, fine-tuning it, you'll eventually, like, fix it. I mean,
so
why not?
What's the name of the movie? So pretty much Live, Die, Repeat, whatever the name of the
actor. Dude, yeah. Live, Die, Repeat was so underrated.
That was a pretty good movie.
God, actually, that movie was so cool.
Restart.
It's like Groundhog's Day if, like, you put, like, adrenaline and shit in it. Oh, my God. Dude, I don't care what people say. I love Tom Cruise. Like, he's a crazy motherfucker, but that dude makes some good movies.
Yeah, honestly, I'd have to go with the rewind button, too. There's so many things that you just, like, goof up in life. You're like, oh, no. Oh, crap.
Yeah, let's...
I would only ever rewind stuff, like, right after it happens, though. Like, I wouldn't go back, like, however many years to, like, fix it. Think about it, because then you have to live through the entire, like, rest of it.
Yeah, but then you could, like, use that ability to, like, freak people the fuck out. It's like, oh, man, I remember what's going to happen next. It's like, yo, watch over there. And then, like, people think you're, like, a fucking wizard.
Or you could just win the lottery, actually. Didn't think about that one. Yeah, too.
Yep.
But what if that ruins your life? Woo!
I just win the lottery again.
There's another movie. I forget what it's called, but they actually, like, went back in time.
The one with Ashton Kutcher?
No, it's recent.
Oh.
It was, like, I think it's called, like, I don't even know what it's called, but basically, like, they went back and won the lottery, and then they totally, like, messed stuff up, and then, like, people on a plane died, and, like, dude, is bad. But anyways,
is this a Disney Channel movie? Because I feel like that was a Disney Channel movie.
Disney Channel, yeah, original Disney Channel film.
Movie where people die. Okay,
Minutemen.
That's not a Disney Channel movie,
but it was on the Disney Channel.
Okay, but the pause button is, like, the stupidest thing. It's just like, okay, you can pause it, but, like, it's still gonna happen. So
no. I think what he's saying, if you read a little bit further down, it says be able to slow down everything around you. You're unaffected.
No, that's the second
this.
Question.
No, the second question is after or. This is still part of the first question.
No,
like hit show.
That's
hit show
first
more.
Question.
Hit show no. more.
No, I already did.
No, you didn't.
No, he does the be able to slow time around you thing, and just watch this or choose a specialist ability. Those are the two choices. He just explained them.
What specialist ability? Like like gravity.
Who's in charge of this podcast?
Definitely.
Who's in charge of this podcast? Who are you? You're a guest. So place.
I'm gonna go out on a limb here and say I'm gonna get reject. So then when I die,
oh
I can respawn.
Okay, so for those of you we haven't even read it. To be able to slow down everything around you, you're unaffected by this, but everything else is. But you'll age faster than everyone else because relativity. Woo! And just watch the world in slow motion, or choose a specialist ability in BO3 to have in real life. So Greg said reject for obvious reasons. Anyone else?
I like glitch.
Yeah, dude. I was gonna choose the glitch too. It's like if you're in an awkward situation, you're like, boop, I'm out.
I'm out.
And then people are like, wait, you're just like 20 feet away. Like, yeah, but I'm 20 feet more away from you. And then you just run. And then you just then you run.
I think I'd go with gravity spikes.
Just John
just
Cena, like, everyone.
Just, like, just walk
his
in.
Name
like,
is John all right, Cena! All right,
guys. All right, guys. You got a math test today.
Gravity spikes.
Dun, 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 dun. Just blow away entire buildings to blow off like small chores.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, so.
No, I'd rather do the slowdown time thing. That'd be more useful.
Oh, dude, some guy replied to that, Arctic Fire HD, and he goes, glitch, when I walk into my mom and dad's room when arguing. Wow, yes. That was sad. Oh, man. You okay there, buddy?
Bad day?
Bad day? Then he actually has a question. Oh, God, it's another zombie apocalypse question. I don't know if I want
to. And now to answer the weekly zombie apocalypse
question. Okay, fine. You can choose four people to survive. No, no, we've already done this. No, no.
Yeah, we have already done this. So.
No, I'm sorry, Arctic Fire, but no, people, no more zombie questions. Jesus.
I like zombie questions.
You can go fuck.
I like zombie questions. I'm awesome.
Avery Campbell, two questions. What is your favorite gun in the beta now? and beta's over, idiot.
That's not his fault.
I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. And two, what is something in Black Ops 3 beta that should be nerfed? I'll let you guys take this because I didn't play it.
Can we just do this one quickly? Gun was the M8A7 by far.
Until they nerfed it.
No, even after they nerfed it, it was still good.
They didn't say best gun, though. Favorite gun.
Favorite gun? M8A7. There you go.
That was my favorite.
Nerf is stun grenades.
Yeah, but you got attack mass, though.
But, like, even... But they're still so overpowered.
I've never played it, but, like, does attack mask, like, help all that much?
Yeah, attack mask is amazing. It doesn't affect you at all.
Well, then there you go.
It was fair, I think.
But problem
then again,
is...
like... But then again, I hate, like, it's, you know, it's like the whole thing of, like, they didn't want toughness because they didn't want to have it to be a crutch perk. Well, same with fucking Tac Mask.
Yeah, no, seriously, Tac Mask and Flak Jacket are basically crutch perks. And so is Awareness or Sixth Sense.
I never used that. I didn't have a problem.
Black Hats.
The Black Hats I heard are freaking amazing.
Which they are, is what I heard.
I heard the Black Hats are overpowered as fuck.
They hack everything.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Everything.
They hack dogs. Woo!
Those don't exist anymore.
The best is when you hack a wraith and get like 8 more kills from it.
Yeah, like theirs doesn't go off, and then you hack, and all of a sudden,
no,
it's like,
dude, I probably got over 100 kills in the beta just by hacking wraiths.
Honestly, I like the Black Ops 2 Black Hat, where if you pointed it at something, it just kind of blew it up. You didn't actually get control over it. You didn't have to carry a rocket launcher. You could have a good secondary, and then you could
The Black Hat was pretty nice. Dude, I loved it for, like, the equipment, like, the bouncing buddies and stuff, because it was so freaking quick. Like, even if you didn't, like, it was useful, too, because, like, you didn't necessarily have to have engineer. Like, it made it easier, but it's, like, you could just run a Black Hat, and it's, like, if you knew people were, like, camping in a room, you just kind of, like, point it at the room and just kind of, like, you know, paint the wall with it until you find it, and then, like, because it only takes, like, half a second. That was
And then again,
you have the EMP grenades.
In Black Ops 2, I was a scumbag with the Black Hat because on the first weekend, everyone was calling in care packages on Nuketown 24/7. And if you had a Black Hat, you could capture the care package before they could capture their own.
They eventually nerfed it and made it take longer. Yeah, but I did that all the time.
That was like the funniest thing. And even like in the beta, I would like... throw my care package like really far away and then like lay down like behind a bush and someone would like look around and then they'd go up to the care package and like when they're about to capture it then I would capture it with my Black Hat.
Well, dude, one of the things in like Black Ops 2 that I hated with the Black Hat is like, you know, it's like the EMP grenade, it's like enemy destroyed your, you know, equipment. Why the hell would I use the Black Hat if it tells them the same thing when I could just throw an EMP grenade, it takes out their minimap, destroys their stuff, and, you know, all this crap. So I don't know why
it would have been nice if it didn't tell you that they
like that would be the advantage over the Black Hat, especially since it's single use. But okay, so five questions, seriously. G-dubs, what's your favorite movie? Let's go quick with these guys.
Oh wow! This is
so quick.
Batman, Dark Knight.
I really enjoyed Ant-Man recently. It might be my favorite right now.
Straight Outta Compton was very good.
My favorite movie of all time is cheesy, but I'd say Forrest Gump. You can't go wrong with it. All right. Garge or Doom Clan?
I like Garge. Garge's
cool guy. He's a weirdo, but he's a cool guy.
You call me a liar. I hate him.
Dude, Garge is into tentacle hentai, so I'm not going to judge him for that.
Okay.
All right. What's your favorite food? Italian, and if I want to be specific, chicken fettuccine. It's good stuff.
Buffalo chicken.
I really like chicken fried steak, mashed potatoes, and gravy.
And
beautiful stuff.
Okay. What's your favorite COD? Black Ops 2. Yeah, Black Ops 2.
MW2.
No, you have to pick one.
MW3 or Black Ops 3.
Yeah.
Okay, Black Ops.
All right. Xbox or PSN?
PSN.
One of us.
Wait, no. Why do you guys say that though?
Because it's
just
better.
Because the PS4 is better than the Xbox One.
No, they're saying the network, like he said PSN, so it's like Xbox Live or PSN.
PSN.
Well, PSN was free. So.
Yeah, but then again,
it was free on PlayStation 3. And
yeah, but you get your information stolen.
I didn't put any information on there.
I know. I'm just saying, it's like they get hacked all the time. So,
Well, now they both get hacked because Lizard Squad.
Yeah. I think the question was broken because Lizard Squad aren't hackers. Live.
They're just DDoSers. That's not hacking. DDoSing is not hacking. Give me a break.
No, it's not. It's just flooding a router.
Dude, it's not hard to do.
It's flooding servers.
Yeah. Okay, that's it for the questions. Let's get on to our main talking points now.
Alrighty. So, guys, we have some interesting topics as usual. As you guys may or may not know, there was Jimmy Kimmel. He has a late night show during the week at like 12 or 11:30 Eastern time every night on ABC, and he made a video segment in his thing where basically he was making fun of YouTube gaming, which if you guys didn't know, it came out last week, and basically said how like it's stupid to watch people play video games, and he
Let's be honest, it is.
I mean, it is, but people watch it for, you know.
But then again, so is watching sports.
Yeah, and basically the funniest comment that I read was, "Why watch porn when you could have sex?" Which was funny.
But then again, like that's so it's like, oh man, why didn't I think of that?
Yeah. So like the whole like concept of it, right, is actually kind of funny, and like for someone who doesn't understand, it is a little bit weird. Like, how is it entertaining to watch people play games? Like, it makes sense that you'd be confused. The problem I had with it was that it just wasn't really that funny. Like, there was a better way to do it, and the entire thing was ripped from South Park.
Yeah, dude, it was so not funny. It was like I was watching like Jay Leno, where he's like, "Yeah, have you guys heard about this like YouTube game stuff?"
For me, it was more like it. I don't get offended by things, so I don't get offended by things all that easily. So if it was just a joke, it would have been okay. And like, okay, I get it, it's a joke. But he seemed malicious about it. Like, he was really genuinely trying to make everybody in the gaming community
it felt
mad.
Like, he was being like, "You guys are a bunch of nerds."
Yeah, pretty much, he was like the jerk in the school.
There was like over.
Oh, yeah, classes.
I'm sorry, I can't take the ex-host of the Man Show seriously. Yeah, no one's gonna know what that is.
Well, as we're recording this, it has 960,000 views, 116,000 dislikes, and 7,000 likes.
YouTube view counts are broken.
So it literally got destroyed. I mean, there's a ton of like big FaZe people and that sort of thing commenting on it. Which
isn't Thunder like the top comment right now?
It depends who. But anyways, but,
it was like ignorant. It's like, you know, it's like an old person, like, "I don't understand this," you know, stuff like, so it's like, I can't get too mad at it. And plus, like, there's a grain of truth in it. Cause like, yeah, it's kind of sad. But then again, like, ESPN has been broadcasting freaking poker for how long now? Like, are we really going to get too upset about video games? Like, I mean, are we considering poker a sport? Like, really, is that a sport? It's like, "Daddy, why are we bankrupt?" Because your dad's a terrible athlete, son. Like, is this how society works now?
I mean, he made a second video replying to comments, which was really funny, in my opinion.
No, it was not funny
Some of the comments were really funny, like, especially when they called him a degenerate and stuff. But the really cool thing is, when we're actually recording this, tonight Markiplier is going to be on the show, so I think that's going to be an interesting show, because
it could go really well or really poorly.
Wait, Markiplier, aka American PewDiePie?
Yes, and he has like the most amazing voice.
I take offense to that, but move on.
I'm sorry, I don't watch YouTube Let's Players. I can't stand the fake reactions.
He doesn't have a high pitched voice. He has a really, really deep
voice.
He's
got a voice made for radio.
No, I realize that, but I'm just saying, like, I can't stand the fake reaction, like, people like, "Oh my god, I'm so scared, oh my god."
I would say Mark will do that, but continue.
The reason I like Markiplier so much is because he made an 8 million subscriber video, and he was literally, like, crying.
He doesn't really fake things. He's more genuine about it. And I met the dude in real life, I've held a conversation with him. And it's like,
no, I'm not saying he's a fake person, but like, I mean, we all like, I just don't like that like persona of like, you know, they're playing Five Nights at Freddy's or something. You know,
are you talking about
like,
Markiplier or PewDiePie?
Both. Like, I don't watch them. Like, I don't watch either of them, but like, I've seen a few videos from them, like playing the Five Nights at Freddy's, and like it's a jump scare. Okay. It's startling. It's not like, "Oh my god,
I've watched a couple Five Nights at Freddy's from Markiplier and stuff. Like, I'm not subscribed to anything, but I found them pretty entertaining to watch like every now and then.
I've been playing, Sorry, go ahead.
No, it is sort of true to an extent what Eggie's saying. Like, sort of the whole, like, jump scare thing is, like, you know, you don't react like that. It's just...
Yeah,
it's,
no one reacts like
that. It's just not... Life. Especially when you've been playing it for such a long time. Like, you learn to predict them, basically.
Okay, so here's the deal about this, and I want to just kind of get this out of the way. I'm, as someone who's actually done horror Let's Plays for an extended period of time, I did it for an entire summer... Though when I play it solo, I don't have those reactions.
Yeah, exactly.
When I play it solo, I don't have those reactions. But when I'm playing it for the camera, I hype myself up for it.
Yeah, you got to put on a show.
I'm sitting there saying, so it's fake.
I'm sitting there and I'm talking
to the show.
But the thing is, I'm sitting there talking to the camera. I'm trying to hold the conversation while at the same time kind of a little bit on edge, not knowing when this jump scare is going to happen. So I'm automatically holding a conversation. And if you're in the middle of talking and something jumps out at you, there's a possibility that you're going to jump and yell or do something because you're already kind of
perfect example of this. So
I got something after Greg
recently. I started a second channel for Let's Plays, and the first game I'm playing is Until Dawn, and there's this part where you have to look for spray deodorant, and basically you reach down or you open up the cabinet to get it in the bathroom, and a Wolverine freaking pops out at you, like, as you're like concentrating on grabbing the freaking deodorant. Like, I was legitimately scared. Like, I literally went like a foot back in my chair.
And I really want to play Until Dawn. I've been avoiding watching videos of it so I can game. Play it.
So I have an axe to grind. Okay, I have two things to say, and one I'm gonna get out of the way really quickly is, like, you know, this whole thing is kind of goes back to, it's like, yeah, it's, you know, stupid, but it's like, you know, supply drop opening videos are stupid, but then again, there's the argument of, like, people can watch whatever they want. Like, if it entertains some people, then fine. Like, it's easy content, but, you know, whatever. Let them do whatever they want. So, like, you know, think if it's stupid if you want, but if people are entertained by it, then go ahead. But here's the thing I want to bitch about is I hate horror games. And not because, like, oh, you're just a pussy, you can't play them. No. There's no good horror games, because all horror games now are just jump scare. Jump scares are not scary. That doesn't make it scary. And same with horror movies, too. The jump scares are not scary. They're startling, okay? If, like, right now, if a fucking, like, possum jumped through this window and landed in my lap, yeah, I would be very startled. But it doesn't make it, like, the marsupial equivalent of, like, fucking Stanley Kubrick in The Shining, okay? It's not scary. Scary is, like, building unease. And, like, Until Dawn is, like, the only game that I've seen in a long time that kind of does... Like, it does have way too many jump scares, and by way too many, I mean more than one. Jump scares are cheap, but, like, it does build a nice atmosphere of, like, kind of building tension where
there's so much tension, dude. Like,
yes, there is, but, like, the whole thing is that it's essentially, it's not actually scary. Like, it's tension building. It's like the Dead Space games. They're not scary because it's all a bunch of jump scares. Like, I can't stand them.
How many horror games in recent times have you watched somebody play, or have you played personally?
I play quite a few.
Because
I don't really watch Let's Plays, though, but I don't get scared. I get startled because it's like jump scare, and it's like, oh shit. But it's not like I'm playing the game.
I've played
like, oh,
a
shit,
lot
I'm
of
scared.
These indie games that come out because they're free and I don't have to pay for them. But I played a lot of these indie games, and you're right in the aspect that but there's quite a few out there that are just jump scares, and there's no build to them at all. It's just, yeah. Oh, look,
Five
jump scare.
At Freddy's
and I get
terrible.
No, I can't take that as, that's not a good example, because I feel like they build the atmosphere in that game. It does get boring after a little while. And Mark's even had this thing go on where he sat there and played through the first game, and after like maybe the fifth episode, he doesn't get jump scared anymore. He doesn't react to it anymore. He's more just angry and he's dying now. It starts out scary, but it's just no longer scary because you've just gotten used to everything. You've gotten used to the way the sounds are, and it just turns into essentially a stupid puzzle game.
Okay, but the point I'm making is that there's so many games that are like, they're relying on jump scares and being like, you know, like, oh man, this game's so scary, but it's like, why is it scary? You know, just the jump scares are scary. No, they're startling. That's not scary.
I would literally say that Until Dawn, yes, although it does have a lot of jump scares and a lot of cliche, like, horror styles and, you know, ideas and things, it does have a really good story. And I think that that's what the game has going for. Like, honestly, I'd rate the game like a 9 out of 10 as far as
yeah, I think the story's kind of good. It's there's a lot of parts that I've seen in it where it's just like ugh, but like I
well, there's a lot of stupid dialogue. Like the script absolutely.
Oh god, blows. The dialogue. And that's another thing. It's like I hate I hate games and stuff where it's just like they do the dialogue and it's like no one talks like that in real life. Like what the hell? Like no one like. You know, says these things like where are they getting this? And plus, the other thing I have to pick about Until Dawn is like my favorite game series is Mass Effect. I love the story and like everything about Mass Effect. I love. The only thing I do hate about it is that they the dialogue trees. And this is just the limitation of gaming and technology right now. I don't harp on them, but it's the thing that they give you the illusion of. Like control in the games, like they go like, oh, you have so many dialogue options, yeah, but like you still end up no matter like how you get to the basic flow of the conversation still ends up at the same ending point. And it's the same with the Until Dawn. Like if you've seen like people play it and stuff like that, they'll choose like except for people dying and stuff, most of the time your decisions are kind of chosen for you because the game needs to go on. For example, Matt and Emily, like she always.
Spoiler alert! Heads up. Okay.
Yeah. Wait. Don't tell me.
I'm not gonna tell you. I'm just saying, Matt and Emily. Every time, like you have to make a decision as Matt, she just shoots it down, and like you go with the one that the game wants you to do anyways. Like it's just like it gives you the illusion
like
of choice.
How much choice do you want? Like do you like that's really I hard. Mean, honestly, to make a game where it's like
no, they, I'm not harping on them. That, like that's the limits of technology. But I just wish that they would like stop. Like their whole thing is like the butterfly effect. And it's like yeah, there's different endings because people die and stuff like that. But it's like I hate how they like have like it's like oh you said something different in this conversation. The ending's totally gonna be different now. It's like no, it's not.
So my whole like opinion on horror and like just in general beyond sort of games and all that, like I'm not a fan of horror movies. I hate horror movies. The last one I saw, I only went to see like I don't even know why. I went to see it on a date. So like that's like the move is to see horror movies on dates, which by the way is completely the move. Go see horror movie if you're going to go on a date.
Oh yeah, totally.
But so that was the only reason. We saw like The Poltergeist and it was like the shittiest movie.
Oh god, it's terrible.
It's just full of jump scares. And
yeah,
it's
the first one's better.
And so because of the, like I don't understand why people like that. However, on the flip side, I'm going to go like I recently watched an anime that was like supposedly a horror anime and I've been putting it off cuz I hate horror. I was like I do not want to watch this and Tank and Chain were like you need to watch it. It's great. Pussy. And so I watched it and there was like there was two jump scares over the entire like 16-12 episode thing. And the whole thing was just sort of psychological, like, horror. Not even that gory, just, like, thrilling.
Yeah, that's
you know?
What I like.
That's that, and I thought it was amazing.
Yeah,
which
see,
one was
that's
it?
Where it is.
One game. See,
like, here's a good example. Give me, like, your best, like, in the last, let's say, 10 years, what would you guys say is, like, the scariest movie you've seen in the last 10 years or so? Don't think about it too hard. Just be like, oh man,
I mean, that's the problem. Like, I don't watch
The Conjuring.
I really enjoyed The Woman in Black.
I've never seen that, but like, okay, has anyone seen The Conjuring?
No.
I don't watch horror movies.
Yeah, neither do I.
Okay, wow, you guys are a bunch of pussies. But like, the whole thing is that like, the reason why, and like, I will admit, Stanley Kubrick is pretty overrated. But like The Shining is one of the best horror movies in the ever like the because like it's just the concept of it is like you're stuck in this isolated place with a fucking maniac and plus there's like ghosts and stuff like that. That movie is terrifying and it has zero jump scares. But like then you get like movies that like people are like so freaked out about like The Conjuring by like James Wan, who I will give it to him, he's a good director, but like The Conjuring was not scary at all because most of it was like it would pan over and then you would see like the typical like oh my god it's a ghost, but it's just like it's just a person in like pale white facial makeup and stuff like that and it's just like a jump scare. It's like that's not scary, that's just startling. So it's not they don't have good pacing is what I'm saying.
So what would you say about games like Outlast and what's it called, Alien Isolation?
Alien Isolation scary. I mean, there's it's got its fair share of jump scares, but it's the whole thing of like it builds uneasiness and tension, and you feel like the whole time you feel like you're in danger, and it does a fairly good job at not, like, even though you know what Alien looks like, it does a good job of not letting you see it constantly, because when you don't see it and you don't know where it is exactly, that's scary. But things like the game Dead Space, that game is not scary because, like, the monsters are just up in your face constantly, and it just turns into a first-person or a third-person shooter, but it's not scary. Outlast, it's like Until Dawn. There's good parts, but essentially it boils down to a lot of jump scares.
Okay.
I do like the chase sequences when you're having to run from, like, the monsters and stuff like that. Those parts are good. Those parts are terrifying.
Right, let me talk for a sec. I just want to say, like, I really like games that you make decisions. And one game that I think did a better job than Until Dawn is the Walking Dead Telltale games. Yes. And even the other Telltale games. Like, all those games are really, really, really good.
Yeah.
And because, like, people, like, will say, like, after you make a decision, like, so-and-so will remember that.
Yeah.
And it will come back to, like, bite you in the butt, like, later on in, like, another part of the game.
I totally agree with you, but the only thing I have a problem with The Walking Dead by Telltale Games, and this is the only problem I have with it, is, you know that part where you come across the car with the food and supplies and stuff? Dude, I hated that thing because, like the villain at the end, like, even if you, I chose not to, steal from it, yet the guy at the end was, he was still mad at me, and he's like, you stole the food, and Lee was like, no, he didn't, but then instead of him going, like, wait, you didn't? Oh, okay, then he's just like, oh, I still need to punish you. You're like, what? How does that make sense?
Yeah. I think the first, like, season one it was the best. The second one did have good parts.
But the second one you get to play as Clementine, who was just a fucking badass.
Yeah, true.
Oh, God, I love Clementine. She's one of the best characters ever. Okay, so do we got a new topic?
We didn't actually continue our topic. We were talking about Jimmy Kimmel, and we totally got off topic.
Whatever, it's still entertaining.
Yes.
This is funny. Moving on. What else we got? Do we have anything else?
Well, I mean, I was thinking of maybe mentioning my copyright strike thing that happened.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
Because I was going to do a commentary about this, and I might still do one. But basically, as I got a copyright strike because last week or the week before, they leaked the leveling system for zombies along with the actual, like, emblems. And a few other zombie YouTubers put this emblem on their thumbnails. So I thought that it wasn't going to be a problem. So I did the same thing. I ended up getting a copyright strike from Activision, which, if you guys know, a copyright strike's really bad. If you get one, it's not really that bad. It just disables features. And one of those features happened to be live streaming on YouTube, which I did fairly often, so that kind of sucked. And if you get two, then you can't use your YouTube channel for 2 weeks. And then if you get three, your channel gets terminated and you can't make another YouTube channel. Or you can, but they have grounds to terminate you.
Cough, cough, Keemstar.
Yeah. but basically, like, I was so relieved today because it actually got removed. And Activision, like, basically said, like, we're sorry, it was a mistake. And I did end up deleting the video anyways because it didn't even do that well. And it's kind of whatever now. But, like, I was just, like, honestly, throughout this whole time of having this one copyright strike, it was the scariest thing that I could have gone through. Like,
oh my God.
Okay, listen to this, dude.
It's spooky.
When you post on a YouTube channel every single day for over a year and spend, like, all your free time making really good videos, putting a lot of effort into it, and then realizing it can be taken away at a moment's notice because you made one bad decision. Like, that is horrible.
That's fucking life, dude.
Dude, no, seriously. Hey,
Greg, come talk to me about life decisions affecting. No, I'm just kidding. Okay. No, I know. I get what you mean, dude.
But seriously, like, you know, everyone that knows me, they know that I spend a ton of time on my YouTube
channel. No, I'm just flicking you shit, dude. But no, I totally agree with you.
No, I agree with, you know, your circumstance that happened to you, and I don't think that's appropriate for the show.
Greg, I will say that if that's your scariest moment in life and that's the biggest thing, you got a good life going on, buddy.
No, it's not like the scariest thing, but it's just like it's one of those things that, like,
oh no, that would suck dick.
Yeah, dude, it's like working your butt off for something and then never being able to make anything of it.
Yeah, afterwards. It's like, and you can't do anything about it because you're going up against YouTube.
Yeah, and yeah. Like, I was just really, really relieved that it got taken care of, and they basically said, "We're sorry."
That's honestly something that a lot of guys, when they start YouTube, don't even think about. You see, how many small channels with like 100 subscribers or less just upload a video and they have a copyrighted song in their video already. Or something? It's like, dude, you're already starting off on the wrong foot. You're going to get a strike before you even reach 200. You have no idea what you're doing.
Yeah.
It's crazy. Like,
it's just one of those really scary scenarios that I came up with. But like, I just want anyone listening to this that is going to start a YouTube channel, you need to make sure that you're really careful about everything. Because it really can, like, at least for me, yes. And like, even if you're a small YouTuber, don't be serious about this now before you get bigger and then you get bit in the butt because of a stupid decision you made a long time ago. Because that's what it was, it wasn't really that, but like, you know, sometimes there's other stuff that I've just deleted because I didn't want to have to worry about it anymore.
And the stupid thing is about it is, like, they go with the 3-strike rule. So it's like, if, you know, let's say like you had good fortune and like you got to like face status and you're at like 500,000 subscribers. If you got a copyright strike back at like, you know, 1,000 subscribers, and then like all of a sudden you get like the third one at like 500,000, you're done.
Well, it's removed after 6 months. So,
oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought they did.
You don't keep your strike forever.
It lasts 6 months, but the thing about it is it disables a lot of features that are useful. Like, you can't look at your content ID appeals. You can't monetize some of your videos. Even, like, some serious ones. I know for a community guideline strike, which is, like, basically saying you're selling, like, YouTube partnerships and stuff, like, you can... like, it removes your ability to put, like, custom thumbnails, videos longer than 15 minutes. You can't schedule your videos. Like, it's, like, hardcore. And, like, I think that it's good that this system is in place, but at the same time, I feel like it is abused a lot as well.
They need to work out the kinks, like, big time.
Yeah,
the system is a shoot first, ask questions later type system.
but can you blame, like, YouTube's, like, covering their ass?
Well, yeah, like, what happened
was... they don't want to get, like, sued.
Okay, so for people that don't know, what happened was a long time ago, networks were made for this type of thing. They were supposed to police their own channels, but networks got so big and YouTube doesn't trust networks anymore. So they created this copyright claim system so that they could avoid getting sued. Because YouTube got sued, like, what was it, right before Google took over it. Because of people uploading lyric videos and montage.
Dude, I understand how those people do it, like, but then we get screwed over. It's like, why are they able to do it?
Because they live in other countries.
It's one of those things that if you live in the United States, then you actually have to say, like, I agree to, like, go to court through this. That's basically what I had to do. I had to agree that I would, with my, like, legal, you know, like...
Greg and his legal team.
me and my other friends.
And then the judge is like, didn't I hear about this on Jimmy Kimmel?
Yeah, but, like, seriously, like, if you don't live in the United States, you can win, like, a huge majority of your things because the
you
people...
You just need to set your region as, like, the UK and upload through a VPN or something like that. You'll be fine.
Yeah, seriously, like, if... The thing about it is, though, like, if you say, like, basically, for example, if you get striked by Activision like I did, like, Activision isn't going to go to, like, Australia to fight one copyright claim. They're just going to be like, okay, delete the video and we'll remove it. But, like, I was really fortunate that it got removed because, you know, obviously that's good. And I'm definitely going to be a lot more cautious.
And look, this isn't just something that happens to Greg or every so often just happens to YouTubers. This could happen to anybody and at any time and for any reason. I'm not kidding.
It could happen to you.
It could happen to you.
We sound like anti-drug programs.
Oprah. You get a copyright strike. You get a copyright strike. Everyone goes home with a copyright strike. But
we're like a scared straight program in prison. Like, I didn't think it could happen to me, but it did.
And it could happen to you too. So look, I didn't get a copyright strike like Greg did, but YouTube has the automated claim system where if you have a copyrighted song, if somebody wants to have your video claimed, they can do it automated. So YouTube will automatically take care of it for you. I didn't have that happen to me. Konami specifically came to my video and copyright notified my video, saying that there was a portion of the video that I was not allowed to use. It was some cutscene or something. There was a song in the background that they were claiming. And what you got to understand, I'm with Maker Studios, so I have the rights to play pretty much any game I want and monetize it. But companies don't care. They don't care that so-and-so bought the rights out, whatever. They will still claim your stuff sometimes. So
wasn't it like the thing with Grand Theft Auto is like people, like when they played it, they immediately had to turn off the radio inside a car or something like that.
Yeah, because you'd have actual songs, though. Licensed
and they're like, I remember seeing a few playthroughs and like people, they got into the car and like the radio was on. They're like, fuck. Like it played for like 2 seconds and like, they're like, oh man, I'm going back and like muting that part of the video.
I mean, like, you can do like up to 10 or 15-ish seconds.
5 seconds.
I don't know. I just remember seeing like a play, like a video, and this guy got in the car and like he didn't realize it, and then he's like, "Oh shit, it's been playing, crap!"
And then there's also videos on YouTube where they like get in the car and then for like it's muted for like 30 seconds before they shut it off, like they removed it automatically, like on YouTube, like. Through the video editor, they remove the song, and it's just like silent.
You're talking about those like in-car vlogs when someone accidentally has a radio on or something.
No. Oh. I'm talking about like on GTA. Like,
oh, okay.
They're literally driving in the car, and then you see them like turn off the radio like, 30 seconds later, and that like whole part where all the music was playing,
the video was just muted. Yeah.
I have seen people like make vlogs and get in cars, and the radio will be playing. And you'll just, like, see on the vlog that the people are talking about something. You cannot hear them, though, because it's muted. you see their lips moving. There's no audio.
Well, that's... I had something like that where I made a montage, and it was shitty. But, it was a two-song montage. But yet, like, both of the songs were by the same artist. The first song, totally fine. The second song, like, they did the copyright thing. And, like, so the second half of the video is just muted. I was, like, I went back and, like, watched it, like a few weeks ago. I'm like, oh, I wonder how, this is doing, or, see if there's any new ratings. And then I was like, what the titties is this? I was like, oh, my God.
It could happen to you.
All right, so do we got anything else? Like, what are we running out of time? Aren't we at, like, 40 minutes or so?
47.
All right. You think we should wrap it up? Especially since my parents are like starting to vacuum all of a sudden.
yeah, I would say so.
Oh, that's perfect. I think it's a good time to wrap this shit up. All right.
Thank you guys for watching. We appreciate it. Thank you, Vacuum, for ruining the end of the show. And
yo, bitch, shut the fuck up. Jesse, is that you? Yeah, bitch. What's up? It's been a while. I thought you're dead. What? Jesse Pinkman doesn't die. Here. Heroes don't die, but legends live on forever. Leave that in the comments if you know what that reference is, bitch.
I'm pretty sure you just completely fucked that up.
You know what? I don't. Fuck yeah, I did. I mean, damn it. Yo.
Well, this outro is gone.
Outtakes. Yo.
We can't do this shit.
All right, hopefully you guys enjoyed the podcast. If you did, make sure to drop a like, leave a comment below, or a question for us to answer in the next podcast. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Again, thank you to Phil, our guest, for coming on the show, and thank you to Greg for hosting this again. Eggy was here too. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. My name is Destructinator, and we're out. Peace.
Magnets, bitch!
Oh my god.
Wait, no, didn't it go like heroes live on, but legends never? Or wait, what is the quote?
Heroes live, but legends never die.
Yeah, heroes live on, but legends never die.
Yeah, you said heroes don't die, and neither do legends.
No, I didn't say that. I said like heroes don't die, but legends live on. It's the same basic thing. Shut the fuck up. You throw like a girl.
Oh yeah, here you go. Heroes live forever, legends never die.
Oh my god.
Or no, heroes get remembered, but legends never die.
Oh my. Please. No. No more.
Well, you know what, Nader? You throw like a girl!
Remember, kid? Heroes get remembered, but legends never die.
That's supposed to be Obama.
The Great Bambino! No, that's Babe Ruth.
Good.
Alright, guys. Thanks for watching. We'll see you later. Peace. Wait,